Hey, what is good? What is good? What is good? Beautiful people. Of course, you know who I be. Good Doc, Dr. Mike TV, back again once again. Interesting video topic for you guys today. First time to the channel, like, sub, subscribe, notify. Do all the good things to make yourself well-versed in the Good Doc's content. I'm not going to show you my face today while I'm driving. I'm just going to let you guys watch the road because we's on the road again. All right. So had a subscriber hit me up, and he's like, Doc, how do you get over a long-term relationship, right? And I got to be honest, I've never been in a long-term relationship that ended either abruptly or over time. So I tried to make sure that I explained to him that that's never happened to me, and prayerfully, me and the meme want to see this one through until the end. Again, I'm not the predictor of futures or whatever's going to happen is going to happen. But you hope and pray that you see your relationship through to the end if that's what you're going to get into. I'm not getting into a relationship to dip on that bitch tomorrow. Okay? So he asked me that, and I said, you know what? The one thing that I can tell you not to do, and you're not going to like this one. Gentlemen, I know you're not going to like when I say this, but you cannot fuck your way through the deterioration of your relationship. What do I mean by that? If you just you and your significant other just are no longer together anymore, and you're angry and you're upset or whatever it may be, because guys, I don't give a fuck how you feel, man. Actually, I do care how you feel, but I don't give a fuck what you say. You're going to feel something. All right, if you've been in a relationship with somebody for a significant amount of time, I don't care if it's a couple years, 5 years, the duration of your relationship really doesn't matter. If you were in it long enough to feel something, if it all falls apart, guys, I'm telling you, you're going to feel something. But the one thing that I do not encourage you to do is to try to screw or have sex with other women to try to get over it. It's just not going to work. I'm telling you, you're going to feel more emptier doing that than anything in this world. Now, again, I understand everybody who lives that red pill lifestyle, man. That is your way of life. That is what you're going to do. And hey, if you realize that relationships ain't for you and you just feel like, yo, man, I'm just going to be a player for life and I'm just going to, you know, be with women as I deem fit and, you know, not worry about marriage or anything like that or relationships, hey, do your thing. But for anybody who's been in a relationship and who's about to get out of one, or whether it be divorce or whether it just be a relationship that you have with your significant other that falls apart, I can honestly tell you that trying to screw your way through it or trying to have sex with other women to try to get over it ain't gonna help you. It's just gonna make you empty. I've seen it happen to the best of them. A very, 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 very close person in my life has gone through this. I mean, me and my mans is my mans and shit, right? And I seen how it took a toll on him. And, you know, like I said, man, he could get girls. It was never really the issue about him getting girls. It was just he was getting girls, but yet and still he was going home alone. And, you know, the house in which he shared with his significant other, you know, the shit was just empty to him. And I realized that it hurt him more to do that than actually just trying to deal with it and trying to get over it on his own, getting over it on his own, you know? I'm not saying that you got to jump into anything brand new. I know us as men, we're taught not to feel. We're taught not to have any type of emotions. You know, we're taught that shit, and it's real. Dude, we are taught that shit. So, in fairness, when I was going through it, or I was with him when he was going through it, I saw all the emotions that he went through, and I realized it just wasn't helpful for him to try to get back into the dating market like some people would tell you. You got to deal with it and you got to address it, guys. That's all I can tell you, because I don't know how your emotions are. I don't know how you feel about and or deal with certain situations, but what I will tell you is this. If you feel like, you know, getting it in with other women is your best method, you do it. I'm not going to tell you not to. I'm just going to tell you I don't feel like that's going to help you. The best way to deal with it, talk to your boys, man. Your trusted confidants, man. Have genuine conversations with your boys and shit. I mean, and tell them, look, man, you know, you going through it. Because your boys ain't going to judge you, man. Trust me, I'm not going to judge you. If you want to cry it out, motherfucker, have a cry session. Just don't do it in front of everybody else. You don't do that in public. You know, that's a private matter. You know, you just got to hold that down and, you know, don't make it a public thing. All right? So, for him, I just encouraged him, yo, man, you got to just take it a day at a time, man. You do what you do feel, you do what you deem necessary, and you do what you feel is right in the moment, okay? Because, again, you can't really sit there and say, well, I want to do this, 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 and this, or you should do this, this, and this, because everybody's relationship and situation is going to be different. That's been a good talk, man. Y'all take care. Stay blessed.
Peace.